was pretty dicey there.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, they played us real tough there. We knew it was going to be a battle. You know, I think they had the same, you know, previous 10 record coming in 7-2-1, and they're playing well. We were playing well, and a lot of chances both sides. And feel real fortunate to get that goal late there. Yeah, it feels great, you know, just to get back in the win column again and get back on the ice is always nice. 2.5 week break is quite a long time without playing a game for a goalie, and it's good to get the win.
Can you process the importance of that rush as it's coming to you? I mean, that game could be on the line there as a goalie. Can you think about that sort of thing?
You know, that could happen in the first period, and, you know, it could be the same result. So you try not to think about, you know, third period, but, you know, time's running down, and it's just you know, try to come up with a save, and I was fortunate enough to do so.
How did you guys get back to being the team you were after that game one, which you didn't sort of resemble yourselves at all?
Yeah, we just, you know, got back to our strengths and what we did good throughout the season, why we finished first. You know, playing the body and going crashing the net and playing gritty. That's playoff hockey right there, and a couple bounces went our way tonight, and playing hard the rest of the way.
It's fitting that the Blandina, Walrod, Cox line got the probably the biggest goal, don't you think? Because that's the way you guys have to win.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, our third line's been great for us all year, and, you know, they've been playing like our first line as of late. You know, they're putting the puck in the net, and they're doing a great job.
Feel like you can exhale a little bit, because, you know, it's a little dicey. If you don't
it was closer at the end. They got that goal there at the end and made it a one-goal game, but I think, you know, the way we played throughout the entire game, all the boys knew that we were going to come through, and we did. So
the goal to take the lead there, that was kind of your, that line's kind of goal, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, and it wasn't pretty, but that's how we play. You know, we throw stuff at the net, everyone crash, hope for the best, and it worked out for us.
Is there something to be said about getting that group back together, the Cox?
I think so. We call ourselves the 10th Cavalry, because we just go to work, and we all work hard, and that's what we love about each other. We're all comfortable with each other as well, because we've been playing with each other all year. So
when you're down 1-0 and it's tied late, I mean, as a player, are you processing the gravity of the situation?
A little bit, but I mean, it's such an intense game that you're more worried about what's going on in the moment than, you know, the bigger picture of the whole series. So you just want to do what you got to do on that next shift, and that's what you want to focus on.
You feel like you brought it back to the way you played the last 6 weeks or so tonight?
Yeah, that was our goal. Everyone was upset with our performance on Thursday night, and we didn't feel like we played the way we should. And tonight we wanted to come out and prove ourselves that we could do it.
You dominated the first period, but when you go to the room, it's still 1-1. Was that difficult to?
It wasn't. The scoreboard wasn't reflective of our play. I think we played really well, and all the boys were happy with the way we played, and we just wanted to keep doing that, and it worked out for us.
What were the 24, 48 hours like after, between game one and game two around it?
Usual stuff. There's nothing we changed. It's business as usual. We didn't do anything special. We knew we had to come and play today, but that didn't change our attitude or the way we practiced or anything else. So,
what do you think about going to Fort Wayne to play? It's a tough place to play.
It is a tough place to play, but
we had
a good year, and you know, we played well in that barn. We took two games from them earlier this year, so I think all the guys are ready to go play out there.
How satisfying is it for you? You're not a goal scorer necessarily, to get that big goal. I mean, that's got to be pretty.
It feels great. It does. I've been on a cold streak lately. Some of the guys have been calling me Mr. Freeze because I can't find the net. But today it seemed to work out, and I got a goal there for us. So.
You almost had earlier that little chip thing.
Yeah. Cox had a good shot and almost got the rebound, but it was close.
What are you guys doing to loosen up the rookies?
Not much, actually. I mean, it's the end of the year, so most of the rookies
aren't rookies.
No, they're not rookies anymore, and that's the way we treat them. They're part of. They're just as everyone else is. We got a team as one, and you know, that's the way we look at it.
The tone coming out of the tunnel tonight. You guys just took it to them. Completely different than you were on Thursday. Talk a little bit about how you guys get to that point.
Well, first of all, is coaching. Larry challenged us the last few days. We didn't play a good enough physical game on Thursday. We didn't play hard enough Thursday. So our coaching staff really challenged us to play a different way. And I think we came out and responded. I think it was a gorgeous game for us. I think we played, everyone contributed, everyone played the way they had to, and it showed.
What about the refereeing? And I'm not making a critique of the referee, but in the playoffs, more things get, you know, happen. Do you guys adjust your game for that?
No.
No?
No. We don't play for the refs.
No?
We let the refs do what they have to do. We try to let Larry handle it, but as far as refereeing goes, we don't try to change our game at all.
No, just, okay. Certainly you guys were back-checking, forechecking all over the place. They're going to be a little black and blue.
Yeah. That's playoff hockey, though, right? That's they'll put us together at the end of the year.
Yeah. How does it feel compared to being on the West Coast last year where is it a different atmosphere where this is more tighter?
You know what? It's the same thing. It's hockey over there. It's hockey over here. There's minor differences between the two sides, but at the end of the day, it's just 60 minutes, one team versus another, and it's playoff hockey. Like, anything can happen. You saw it. It's enjoyable, and we're here to have fun with it. So.
Okay.
We've been just working hard all year, and we've been actually producing pretty well in the last few months. So they call us the Cavalry now, so it's kind of a little nickname.
It was good to get that line back together. Do you think that was part of turning around what happened in game one?
Yeah, I think game one, you know, we got some new guy, like Galliot is down here, and he's just trying to line with, get some new lines going, and it's tough to get chemistry going in one game. So I think he wanted to go back to, you know, what we're used to there a little bit with Meacocks and Blandina. And, you know, we stuck to the Marino line all night, and I think we shut him down pretty well, and we also, you know, contributed in the third period, too.
What's the mood of the team like as this gets down to the last few minutes? You lose this game, you're in big trouble. I mean, are you guys able to process that as it's happening?
I mean, it's in the back of your head, but you got to keep positive. And, you know, we've been all working them all game. We felt like the first period especially, we came out flying, hitting, shooting. And, you know, it's just like you got to keep a cool head and just keep plugging away. And then, sure enough, we got the bounce.
The ECHL is weird because guys come down and teams look different in the playoffs. You were such a huge part of this. How tough was it to have to watch in the game?
It was tough sitting out for sure, especially when you're up in the stands watching. It really sinks in. You want to be out there. But, you know, I'm a rookie, and it's tough. You know, they're trying to fit in guys from Hershey, and we didn't really have any guys sent down all year, so it was a new thing for me. But, you know, I just kept positive, and I got in the lineup tonight, and I think I played pretty well.
Did it feel different in your first playoff game, being out there?
Yeah, I had a little bit of butterflies before the game, for sure. Just try to keep it simple and just throw my body around and just get the puck deep. But by the second and third period, I thought, you know, settle down a little bit and get into my own.
Do you feel like you've settled into this series now? Because 1-1, now you can, you know, sort of exhale and get back to business going Fort Wayne.
I don't know about exhaling. You know, it's you gotta just keep bringing that every time. So we're probably... Give us 10 minutes here, you know, to celebrate a little bit. But after that, it's game three, so got to look forward to that.
You had a full year, and now you've got one playoff game under your belt, so you're not a rookie anymore. Do you realize that? Does that sink in?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, it sinks in for sure. You know, they don't treat you like a rookie anymore, for sure. The guys are treat you just like one of everyone. So, yeah, it's a good feeling to get that first game under my belt, for sure.
The empty netter. Were you going to take it all the way down and skate it into the net?
Well,
or what?
I knew I had a breakaway, so I took a peek at the clock, and it was 9 seconds, and I knew, like, might as well just bring it all the way in there and make sure I didn't miss it, just okay. In case.
That's your first playoff goal. When you tell the story, is it still an empty netter, or does it become something?
Yeah, better? Right now it is, but down the road. Like,
from just this side of the red line, right?
Down the road, you know, it was a nice toe drag.